Hello everyone, Drewmatth here today with a video that showcases how to easily climb the ladder with what is, in my opinion, one of the easiest top laners. This will definitely seem like a hyper clickbait video, but compared to others, I will actually explain the reasoning and provide proof that it actually works. Today we will talk about top lane Pantheon, a champion that since rework really started frustrating enemies with his execute Q, invulnerability E and an easy to roam tool, his ultimate. If you haven't seen my other Pantheon video, Pantheon in under 9 minutes for mid lane, check that out as well for the basics. As a proof, I generally climbed my arse out of Diamond 4 Hell up to Diamond 1, both on West and here numerous time on mid and top, but recently I have started playing Pantheon top with Ignite, and as you can see from this picture on the screen, it seems I finally found the champion that will help me reach Challenger for the first time. Oh no, I'm not a Challenger, it surely means I cannot be trusted. Well, considering this win streak and the logistics that I'm about to show you, I will let you decide if it's worth trying or not. As always, always and always, play in normals or flex before trying solo queue, and it is mandatory that you keep at all times a good attitude. I sometimes tilt myself and tend to chat, but that's generally a bad thing to do as it distracts you from the game, so in order to help yourself and help others, just disable chat from the options. Riot was kind enough to give us that option. Another requirement in some context is to try to dodge if you're going for a full AD comp, as Pantheon really hates armor stacking and five tabbies on the enemy team really hurts us. I'm going to quickly rush over summoner spells, runes and build. Basically, ignite and flash for summoner spells, conqueror for runes because of the easy stacking. Here is the page, and this build for items, focusing on early sustain by corrupting and time warp tonic, meretrix for extra tenacity, humus for catching people, black cleaver and death's dance for armor pen, cooldown reduction and tankiness. Finish the build with tank items in general, as you will transition from sort of an assassin bruiser early game to more of a bruiser tank in mid to late game. We're gonna split this section in 3 chapters, but before that, let's just take a quick look at some champions that are deemed the simplest in League of Legends. Those two options that all the people in the game talk about, Garen and Annie. I completely agree that on a micro level they are way more simple than Pantheon and most champions, but compared to Pantheon, none of these champions actually teach you also macro. Pantheon is a great option for learning micro on the lane phase with lots of kill potential against 90% of the matchups. A great option to late macro to learn macro for the 2v2 jungle top fights, and also his insane roaming potential with his ult from top to mid or from base to bot. Playing without teleport further teaches you how to play waves and how to play the lane so you don't get ganked or camped by the enemy jungler. If you do get camped, with Ignite you always have the option to turn on the enemy jungler, but you also gotta consider more risks than usual, and this teaches you more than simply playing Garen and pressing Q to run away or teleporting back to the lane safely. It teaches you how to play smarter in general. For roaming champion, Pantheon is the AD slash tanky slash assassin version of Twisted Fate or Tlia, with a learning curve that's way more forgiving as it deals much more damage than Twisted Fate, and it's much more reliable and tankier than Tlia. For trade and patterns, we'd want at level 1 to do a first Q on the 3 melee minions. Throw a Q on the opponent always to proc bone plating when you first engage on him. Try to Q enemies with the short range Q. At level 2, use your fully stacked W and 2 auto attacks, and then a fully stacked Q, and then back off and repeat. You can now also use E at level 3 to deny enemy damage that comes back. So basically when you get to level 3, you have this ability, you max it, and then you can just instantly cast it. Try to maximize the block potential by predicting enemy abilities, for example, Camille's hook. Every single trade, every single time on lane, use Corrupting Potion and Time Warp Tonic and Biscuits after single trade, after every single trade. So if you get damaged, you gotta be healthy every single time. Do not forget, I see people that forget to use those potions. Do not forget to use potions. You need in some matchups to wait for level 3 to actually be able to kill the opponent, but most of the time you should be able to poke down people. And once they are around 50% HP, after these trades you could just all in, even if you're not level 3 yet. Try to get them low HP enough for an ignite plus stacked Q execute. Basically, if you're both at around 50% HP, against most matchups you will win. For the lane phase, you generally need to follow trade patterns. Don't get cheesed at level 1 by the ignite Shen waiting in the bush. You can always try to invade enemy red if you're blue side with your team, as your ignite and level 1 Q is extremely strong. Start with Q for early poke and at level 2 cast full stack W on the enemy, followed by autos till you stack the bar, then a full Q. Before that, don't forget to proc bone plating. As I told you, this is the most important part, that's why I repeat it. You could also go and push quickly the lane at levels 1-2, so the lane goes into the enemy tower, and then you could go at the blue buff or red buff if the opponent started, if enemy jungle started on the bot side, you could wear their top side buff, and then you know so much more, and also your jungler might invade them, and also you could invade them with him, and so on. Always engage with W when you can, fully stacked, non-fully stacked sucks. If you can stack to conqueror fast, always try to do big Qs on the enemies as well. Don't be afraid to throw it to get a kill because of the execute. Just when you see them low HP, always practice these long range snipes. I generally ban Wukong because in teamfights he kinda counters you with his ultimate, but in the lane phase it's not really hard if you're careful. Another good ban if you struggle against him is Darius. So these are some tips that you could use for your lane phase. And Darius is annoying mostly because his learning curve to lanes plays against that passive. Learn to be aware when Conqueror will proc and play with it, not against it. Go for first bloods whenever you can, it's perhaps one of the simplest champions to get it. You can instant cast E as we spoke to deal some extra burst. No need to keep it up if you're not deflecting damage. As I spoke again, some tricky matchups would be Darius, Wukong, also Irelia and Renekton. This might be some often happening matchups. Darius is banned most of the time by enemies, so you could also ban Wukong or Irelia Renekton. Irelia is not that much played on top, I don't see that often. Renekton may be because of his play rate. You may int against those champions first few games, that's why I'm saying play normal and flex, because they are quite difficult to understand, but they are definitely doable pre-6 and even post-6, especially if you don't play with Ignite. If they play with Ignite, you always have the option to play extra safe until you learn these matchups. Generally, against Renekton, you gotta block if you can the stun with E, for example. Most often matchups, though, are Camilles, Rivens, Rengars. You can just block their incoming damage on their dash with E. You could definitely E the Camille dash, the Renekton stun, the Rengar jump on you, and so on. Again, most matchups, if you cannot win, compared to a Garen against a Vayne, for example, or a Queen, you can just farm safely, wait for ganks, and you also have a gap closer. And then, if you don't really win, you could just roam after a certain point and win elsewhere, which gets me to my second chapter in this discussion, roaming. If you leave your lane, generally in roaming, you take a risk. The enemy will take lots of plates, especially if they are something like Camille. High risk, high reward, it is often better to join your team for a 5v4 than to stay top on a losing lane or even on a winnable lane, because Pantheon does not scale that well. If your team struggles, you can often turn the tide to take first tower bot or a Drake. It is not worth generally to use your ultimate just to secure first Drake, but it's very worth if you get first tower, first Drake, first star or first Drake, and at least one kill. Return to lane and try to come back in farm, and try to defend what's left of the tower so they don't get a free objective. Sometimes I will just walk to mid lane, gank with W, and then ult back top. You can also do that. You can also ult lane if you find like your team wins elsewhere and you don't have really much options. You will see in most cases that the enemy top laner will not follow on the roams. They simply use teleport before to come back to lane because you poke them too much with ignite or kill them. That's an important factor. Only third Drake is majorly important to take, the ones before it can be passed. So focus from the third Drake onwards if you really have to stay on lane. Another tip is to use humus to catch people, that's why it's part of the build. You should always aim behind in teamfights with your ult, you should always aim behind people in mid roams, bot roams, teamfights and so on. You should ult behind the enemy ADC, jump on them and then cast E towards their team and wait for your team to come and help you. So you gotta find the balance, you gotta ult not too far and not too close, so you gotta corner them, and also your team has to have time. This is something that you learn in time. After you ult, you gotta expect lots of CC and damage to come onto you, so a good option is to cast a fully stacked E towards the entire team while also retreating to your team. This happens more in the mid game. In the early game, generally they don't have enough damage to kill you before you kill someone, so you can play more aggressive, and this is where I will go to my next point, team fights. Try to go for magic resist boots unless you are against 5 ADs, because magic resist boots and the rune that you get from the precision tree will help you to survive the CC fast enough so you can cast your E so that your team reaches you. If you don't have time to use E after you casted an ult, so let's say you get Malzahar ulted, you're going to struggle with that, you're going to int basically. So you gotta cast your E before, so magic resist boots giving tenacity helps you a lot. After you had the bad fight and you respawned, try to find with your ult someone who delayed too much the recall. Happens so often and can easily transition in a free soul drake or baron. As the game progresses, as said before, you will transition from an assassin bruiser to a bruiser tank. Your goal as the game progresses will transition from instantly killing the assassin, the mid laner, to actually jumping on them and delaying for your team to reach. You won't really have time in mid late game to kill the ADC, because at that point they will have more dashes, they will have more shields, their support will also scale, won't be that squishy. If you're not able to one shot people, just peel for your ADC. If you're not able to survive the enemy burst, just peel for your ADC, block spells with your E. Again, try to snipe even in teamfights with Q various objectives or champions, you can steal drakes and barons with it. Also, you can try to escape with your ultimate whenever possible if you're chased and the enemy just use their CC, just like a Twisted Fate does from Apache. In conclusion, that will be all for now. I will keep practicing this as well, because I believe he's a great counter to most of the meta on top, even though he's mostly played on mid and on support. On mid, it's harder to play him because of the time your jungler or top laner will not PKP, so most of the time you're going to create full AD comps. And also on the mid laner, on the mid, you generally don't scale that well compared to top. In top, you're not necessarily required to scale if he stomps the lane or does good roams. On mid, the enemy will eventually outscale you regardless, so you gotta see that. You can check the stats on OPGG, he's rarely being played on top anymore, it's more mid or support oriented as we spoke. But you will have the surprise factor with Lightning Flash. With these tips, you should have most of the information required for you to start stomping the ladder and abusing this, as it's a very easy to play champion and an easy to play pick. I really hope this helped you guys. I really want you to practice it if you're watching this video. So good luck on the Summoner Rift. And remember, practice as I spoke will eventually make it perfect. Goodbye guys, and thank you so much for watching this.